Hello students, welcome to Python online classes. Today I'm going to start first class for our Python subject. And today what is the topic is nothing. What is today our topic is list concept. List concept. Already this list concept introduction part is over in the earlier semester. But again, for your understanding purpose, I can explain clearly the introduction part also. Okay. Now let us start our session. Okay. Actually, the list is also one of the sequence. The list is also one of the sequence. First of all, we have to know about the what is sequence. Explain the types of sequences. A sequence is nothing but a data type. First of all, a sequence is nothing but a data type. So in list, we can store a sequence of, a number of elements in the sequence mode. In the sequence mode. So now let us understand about the concept of first sequence. A sequence is an object that contains multiple items of data. That contains multiple items of data. The items that are in a sequence are stored one after the another, one after the other, one after other. Python provides various ways to perform operations on the items that are stored in a sequence. Python provides various ways to perform operations on the items that are stored in a sequence. Here items are nothing but it may be a numbers or it may be a strings or it may be a fruit names or it may be a hotel menu items or it may be a student names. There are number of ways we can use. It depends on our project. It depends on our requirement. Next, there are several different types of sequence objects in your Python. There are several different types of sequence of objects in Python. Here we can see two of fundamental sequence types. Two of the fundamental sequence type. Nothing but these two are very important and remaining also very important, but according to Usmania University, these two are very important in this semester. So first one is list, first one is lists, and next one tuples. Both lists and tuples are sequences that can hold various types of data. Already list option is there. Again, tuple option, why? Actually both are same. There is one of the major difference we have. If you want to maintain any elements, if you want to maintain any elements, any duplicate elements also, if you want to maintain duplicate elements, lists are very useful. Lists are very useful. But if you want to maintain unique data, if you want to maintain unique data, that means you don't want to maintain the duplicate values. For that, tuples are very useful. So here I given that one also. The major difference between lists and tuples is simple. A list is a mutable. Mutable means it can changeable. Once you created the list, in that 10 elements you added, in that 10 students data you added, which means the program can be changed its content. In between one student name I want to change. Actually it has mistaken or it has or one person is went out. One person went from our organization and again one new person came into our organization. Then there I want to delete one name and I want to add one name. So that process is also going on the list. So if you want to add and modify and if you want to change any data, for that a list is very useful. That process is called mutable. Mutable is nothing but a list is mutable means that list can change by any number. That list can change by any data. But tuple is immutable. The second point you have to see here. But tuple is immutable, which means that once it is created, its content cannot be changed. Its content cannot be changed. So that is the difference between lists and tuples. And remaining all those things are same to same. Only one major difference is there. That is unique data and duplicates it is maintaining by the list and unique data maintaining by the tuples. So that is the major difference. Understand the sequence? What is sequence? A sequence is an object that contains multiple items of data. Here every programming language using here any programming language works with only on data, works with only on data. So not more than that. If you don't have any data, then why you need programming languages? Why these many software companies required? If one company maintains sales data or stock data, compulsory one project is required, na? So if that company has multiple locations, multiple branches in the different locations, so that locations also integrated by with the software only. So one place contain different sales and another place contain different sales. But the management, how it will see the total sales, how much it has? So by creating one web application, by creating one software, so there also, so one branch, if one branch contain sales, one branch contain heavy sales, so there people, it can add that sales data. And here also, here management, it can see from one place to another place also. If the MD, he can see the sales data at their home only, at his home. But the office is available in other country. Because of their people adding the sales data there. So through the internet connection, by using that software, the sales data he is looking here. So that is the software requirement. So for that, it can use different options internally. Next, what is a list? Explain different operations on list. A list is, first we have to see the list definition. A list is an object that contains multiple data items. Each item that is stored in a list is called an element. So all of you carefully observe. Here I created one list with numbers. A list can create different data also. Here I created with the numbers list. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. So these 10 is one element, 20 is one element, 30 is one element, 40 is one element, 50 is one element. Total 5 elements we have. So here the variable is numbers is acting as a list because of it is maintaining set of values. It is maintaining a set of values. So that's why it is called a list. The items that are enclosed in brackets and separated by commas are the list items. After this statement, execute the variable. Variable numbers will reference the list as shown in the figure below. Actually, if you use the syntax in the program, in your program, internally it can convert like this. Numbers equal to 10, 20, 30, 40. This is the contingent locations. Nothing but a side-by-side memory it will occupy. In C language, already you have seen an array concept. So this is also same thing. But the terminology is different. Here list I can use. How to create the numbers list? For that, I am opening one IDLE window. All of you look at the screen. It is opening one IDLE shell window. Now I am opening numbers list. Opening square brackets. 10 is one element, separating by comma. 20 is one element, separating by comma. 30 is one element, separating by comma. 40 is one more element, separating by comma. 50 is the last element. If you want to add more elements, then simply add a comma. After that, you can use the number of elements. But if it is a list, compulsory, you can use the square brackets here. That is the major difference between a list part. Now I am pressing enter. So numbers list created. All of you carefully observe. Numbers. I am typing, pressing enter key. All elements it will displaying as output from in the blue color. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. And both sides, square brackets, it is applying. And square brackets are indicating it is a list format. It is a list, numbers list. If you want to identify if it is list or tuples, compulsory you can see the square brackets. By looking at square brackets, you can simply identify it. If it is a square bracket, then it is called a list. Here the name is numbers, so that's why numbers list it has created internally. Now I am minimizing this window. Next, creating a list with strings. Creating a list with strings. Actually, string is nothing but a group of characters. String is nothing but a group of characters. For example, A is one letter, B is one letter, C is one letter, D is one letter. So, if you type any individual letter, it is called a letter. Letter only. Single letter. So, there is no meaning. But if you combine all those things, if you combine a group of characters, nothing but Krishna, Lord Krishna. So, how many characters you have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, around 7 characters if you integrate, 7 different characters if you integrate, one God name it has generated in the name of Krishna. So, a group of characters is called as a string. So, this is also called a string. String. A string is nothing but a group of characters. A sequence of characters altogether is called a string. So, if you want to create a names list, then similarly it can use. But if it is a group of characters, compulsory you can use in between double quotes, you need to write the string. In between double quotes, you have to maintain the string. Because of it is a group of characters. If it is a number, double quotes not required. Because of in keyboard, all keywords contain each one, each letter contain, each key contain one ASCII value. One ASCII value. Understand? So that's why if you press H key internally, it can generate one ASCII number. So that's why for the numbers purpose, double quotes not required. But if you want to maintain a group of characters, nothing but a string value, if you want to maintain, in between double quotes, you need to maintain. Then only it can understand by the Python software. It is a string. Understand? So, if you want to see a variation between numbers and strings, double quotes are required. For the numbers, double quotes not required. For the names, double quotes must and should be required. Now, I am opening IDLE shell window. Again, names list I am creating is equal to opening bracket and closing bracket, opening quotes and closing quotes. Now, here Krishna, I am typing a group of characters. So, one string I have created, and next one more string I am adding. Hari. Next one. Here Krishna is one element, that's why Hari is one element, that's why I am separating with the comma operator from one element to other element. And next, Ali. Next, Rehman. He is also one element, his name also. Okay, na? So that's why Krishna, Hari, Ali, Rehman. So names list I created. Now I am pressing enter. Names list automatically created by the Python software. Next, names I'm typing. Whatever the, now I want to see how many names I have stored. So actually, now here I know 4 elements I added. But after creation of this one, if different operations also going on in the real time project, na, so after 100 statements I have typed in this, again I want to see. Because of I don't know how many elements I added. Because of 1000 statements, in between these two statements, 1000 statements I have executed. That's why I have forget. Again, I want to see how many elements added or else added or not. These many doubts I have. So that's why simply I can type names and press enter key. It will show the, if the content it has, it will show like this. If the content does not have, it will show empty list. Again, then I will add that remaining names. So names list also I have created. List can accept different types also. List can accept different types also. Actually, in the previous I have created numbers list, and presently I created this one, I mean strings list. But I want to maintain all together data, numbers, strings, and floating values, all those things. Because of list can support any type of data, it can support. I mean nothing but any data type it can support. But Python does not. Python internal it can decide the data types. We no need to take any burden for that. So that's why if you want to maintain any values, just you can create the one variable. Here I am creating student information variable. Because of student information, because of I am creating one student result. Here 101 is the number, and Ali is the name. Ali is the name, comma, and his result is 8.5. Here all of you carefully observe, this is number, this is string, this is floating point. Floating point is nothing but it is maintaining one fraction part, na, one digit fraction part it is maintaining. So nothing but float data type is also it is maintaining. String data type is also it is storing, and number data type is also it is storing. Am I correct or not? Now I am pressing enter key. So student info is created. Again I want to see student underscore info. Now I am pressing enter key. So now it is showing blue output, na, blue color output. So all of you carefully observe, a list can contain any type of data. Am I correct or not? So that is the creation of list. So everything, if you want to store any element, after storing, after creation of that one, it can generate like this, a contiguous memory location, nothing but side by side it can occupy the memory, and names also same side by side, and here also 101 Krishna 8.5, the result is also storing side by side. Because of it is a list, it can store as a contiguous locations, memory locations, side by side it can create. So here I given one example for you, how to print the this one, how to print the list items. For your understanding purpose, I am showing one more window. Student information I am printing, numbers. So all of you carefully observe, 10 20 30 40 50. Actually it is a ideally shell, Python shell window this one. So if you type the variable, automatically that list content it has displayed on the blue color output, as a blue color output. But if it is a script mode, nothing but if you want to open any notepad, after that if you want to create any list like this, and it can just create it, it will not show anything while executing time. But if you want to execute that one, compulsory print option must and shouldly you need to use. All of you carefully observe, notepad I am opening. Here list, numbers list I am creating, na, numbers 10 20 30 40 50. So numbers list I created, just created. Again numbers I am using, but here any print statement I have used, na, no, there is no print statement. Now I am saving list. 24 is the name, .py is the extension, save as type is all files. Now I am saving desktop. For that command prompt, for executing purpose command prompt I am opening. Actually the C drive contain users contain Shiva, the location is different. So now I want to shift my location to desktop because of my file is available on the desktop. All of you carefully observe, here I have saved list 24 file is available at desktop. So now I want to change cd means change directory. It is a DOS command, and desktop I have typed here. Press enter key, automatically it can shifted by the desktop location. Now list list24.py. The file name is list24.py is the extension. Here I type it, just pressing enter key. So it is showing anything? No, it is showing only empty place because of you are not print statement. You haven't used it here anywhere. So now I am removing this one. Again, print statement, print function I am using. Numbers, save again. Go to command prompt again. Open again. Type that file name dot with extension. Press enter. Automatically it will display like this. So that is the difference between shell window and script mode execution. Understand? Carefully observe. So here I given numbers, names, student information, everything I have printed. The program name is listExample.py. Here I use it, and this is the output. You simply understand. Not only understand, you just practice. You just practice. If you have any laptop or system, just simply install your Python, install Python software in your system, and opening that one, type this program, save that .py extension with the name of anyone. Name is your wish, but .py is mandatory for the Python file. Then only Python software it will detect. This file is related to Python software, so that's why extension is important. Without extension, if you give anything, then Python software will not detect your program. Understand? So saving is very important with the .py extension for the Python file, Python software. Next, repetition of lists. We can use star operator to repeat a list of the given number of times. We can use star operator to repeat a list for the given number of times. For example, if you write like this, if you write like this, all of you carefully observe. Now I am closing this one. Now I am closing this one. This is also I am closing. This is also I am closing. Again, IDLE shell window I am opening. This is Python command prompt. Here, list I am creating. List equal to 10, 20, 30. Comma must should be required from one element to other element. 50. Okay, list, I have created list into 2. So if you use list star 2, star means multiply 2 times. Here I am telling to the list I am telling to the Python compiler, you print 2 times this list. So list into 2 times. So for that star operator must and should be required. After that, how many times repeated you want, how many times repeated, that that count you need to give here. Here I given 2 now. So 2 times it will repeat. So 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. So from starting to here, this is one list. After that again it is repeating, the second time it is printing. That's why here I given. If you give list into 3 times. So 3 times it will print. All of you carefully observe. From here to here one time. From here to here one time. From here to here one time. Understand? So that is the use of repetition operator. Repetition list. Don't confuse. Here I given one example. In that range function and list function I am using. Actually list function will generate the numbers by using range function. Understand? Here one range function functionality is what? Already in the previous semester you have learnt this. If you want anything, then search in internet. You can understand about the range function. Then only if you research on the internet about this range function, then you cannot forget this one. You cannot forget again. So here range function starting point is 1, ending point is 10. So 1 to 10 it will generate the numbers, but this is the how many increments it is going on. After 1, 2 increments. So 1, if you give 1 here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So all numbers it will print. If you give that 2, only even numbers it will print. Only odd numbers it is printing here. So that's why 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 it is printing. Understand? 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Because of 2 increments it is going on internally. So 1, 2 skipping. 1, 2. Again, 3 it is printing. Here range function is nothing but n minus 1 operation is going on. So nothing but if you give that 2, it is taking n minus 1 operation. So if you want any clarity for this, you need to go through the internet. You need to go in searching through the internet. Then only you can understand about this. So range function has a different functionality to generate the random numbers, to generate random numbers or any required numbers. So it can generate the probations. Iterating over a list with the for loop. We can iterate over a list with the for loop as shown here. All of you carefully observe. For that I am opening one notepad window. Notepad window I am opening. Here creating one numbers list 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. 5 elements I created. For loop I am using. For loop I am using in operator I am using. In means searching by using in operators, and also side I give in numbers list. So numbers list it will search. So here assign the first I is nothing but index 0th index. So numbers is a 10. So I starts with 0, number starts with 10 because of in the 0th index 10 value is there. 0 1 2 3 4. Index starts with 0 na. A list can contain indexes also. In the next option indexes concept you can understand everything about this. So just you can trust here index based list 0th index 1 2 3 4, like that 5 elements we have. Print I value, save. List for dot py, all files. Okay, saving is completed. Again I am opening command prompt window. Again I am shifting desktop because of my file is available on the desktop. List for, okay, list for dot py the file name. Now I am pressing enter key. So all elements it is printing now. By using for loop like this we can also print a list of items. Here I given numbers, but if you want to add a names strings list also you can access like this. There is no difference between this and that, and floating points or multiple objects or combination of anything you can use the list items like this. Next indexing. If you want to access individual elements in the list, list indexing is the better option. Because of indexing starts at 0. Indexing starts with 0. So the index of the first element is 0, the index of the second element is 1, and so on. Here all of you carefully observe, my list is created in a 10, 20, 30, 40. In this list 4 elements we have. So all of you carefully observe this table 10, 20, 30, 40. 4 elements are given, this is list items. In the list 4 elements we have. So how index is going on? Indexing 0th index internally it can maintain, it is not showing this. Okay na? If you want to access individual elements, index is very useful. So the index starts with 0. So 0th index, what is the element we have? 10. And next one, first element index in what element we have? 20. Second index 30. Third index 40. Same thing, negative index also it is maintaining. But from right side to left side it is axing. 40 element has taken minus 1, 30 element has minus 2, 20 element has minus 3, 40 element has minus 4 of the negative index. All of you carefully observe. For that I am opening, closing this window. Again I am opening ideally shell window. For your understanding purpose, I am creating one numbers list equal to 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. ఎందుకు సార్ అన్ని పద్దాక ఈ నెంబర్ ఐటమ్స్ చెప్తున్నారు అనుకుంటున్నారా? numbers plus lo meeku ishtam vachina add cheskondi. But if it is a string, in between double quotes compulsory you need to write the group of characters. I mean string you have to use. If you want to use a string, compulsory in between double quotes you can use. But from one element to another element, one comma operator must and shouldly you need to use. Okay na? Here numbers list I created because of numbers is created along with five elements. Now index basedly I am printing print of. So if you configure numbers 0th index, I am opening and closing this window. Okay na? Pressing enter key. So 0th index, what is the element you have? 10 na? So the 10 value it is printing. Again print numbers square brackets 4th element, now closing this bracket. So 50 is the element. Because of index starts with 0, in the 0th place 10 element we have. First place 20, second place 30, third place 40, fourth place 50. That's why 50 it is printing. If it starts with 0, ending with minus 1. Because of index always starts with 0 in every programming language. Understand? And now we have to see the negative index. Numbers minus 4. Minus 4. Why? NU. Okay. Actually, number spelling I have typed wrong. Wrongly I typed. So that's why. Print opening NUMBERS minus 4 closing bracket. So all of you carefully observe. This is minus 1. This is minus 2. This is minus 3. This is minus 4. So that's why 20 it will print. Understand na? This is negative index. Like this we have to access. Next, length function. Python has a built-in functions named the len that returns of the length of the sequence such as a list. For example, here I created numbers list na, NUMBERS. Numbers list contain 5 elements. So if you have 5 elements, then you can simply see the elements. Just you can count the elements, you can understand. But if you have 2 or 3 lines or for 10 lines of elements you have, then what you have to do? Every time you have to count na? No. Just simply you can use the length concept. Like this. So print of len open numbers list I have passed as a parameter, closing print function bracket and also length function bracket. That's why at last 2 brackets I have closed it. Now I am pressing enter key. So length numbers list contain 5 elements. It is showing na? Index starts with 0 but length starts with 1. Okay na? Index starts with 0 but length function starts with 1. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 like this it is printing. So okay, I am ending today's session. I hope you enjoy it. In the next class I will continue. Lists are mutable concept. Okay na? I will continue from here. Thank you. Thank you very much. Now I am ending this session.